see what you got here. Okie doke.
$19.89. Fair enough.
That'd be worth about $36,000 at today's price. And there's you a check.
Sir, thanks for coming out, man.
Thanks so much.
Appreciate it.
We'll see you later.
I'm lucky, really lucky, that I have a success story. I paid it off my dredge, and I have enough money to take the off-season off, which is what I was looking to do at the beginning of the season.
This check's a miracle to me.
Back at the Pomrenkes.
Hard work's almost over.
This is the fun part of it all, seeing all the yellow.
After cleaning for 12 straight hours, now Steve and Sean are in the home stretch.
We're gonna set up a cooker to dry this gold off.
We'll throw it on the scale and we'll see what we have there.
166.6.
I love seeing that.
This haul is worth almost $300,000.
Nice to see the bills get paid. That's for damn sure. We put 60, 70 grand towards the gold lease.
We didn't beat each other up, so that's good.
Close, but not quite. I love you. Love you too, Dad. I do. I'm just a crabby old guy.
I know. Sometimes.
It's down to Thurber to clean up the concentrate from the sluice box.
Woo! That's some gold there.
The Hoffmans have already mined 1,035 ounces, worth over $1.2 million. But they need a total of 1,300 ounces to keep their claim next season. This last cleanup has to be the best of their lives.
How's it looking?
Well, I'm weighing it up now. 16, 17 ounces.
What?
Holy.
Well, there you go.
217, our best cleanup ever.
217 ounces. Over a quarter of $1 million in a single cleanup.
Hey, John. How's it going?
One of Nome's freelance gold assayers, John Staines, makes a yurt call.
Oh, yeah, you got this really clean. 40.48, $2,174.97. We'll just make it 2175. How about that?
Looks right.
75.
All right. Right on.
The Clark's tally for the second trip of the season: an ounce and a half of gold, almost $2,200 worth. But the biggest haul comes from the biggest dredge.
He should be stress-free, and I'm going to be stress-free.
Steve Pomrenke overcame son Sean's injury, putting the Christine Rose on the gold, 50 ounces, worth $78,000.
Now I'm going to go put this in my hiding spot over here. I keep my gold in various places, but I'm going to put it here right next to my guns tonight.
Scott Foster helped get the sluicey out for its maiden voyage and helped Ian land a 3-ounce $4,700 haul.
Scotty's a good dude, and I'm really, really grateful he's here. Without him, this wouldn't have turned out this way.
So I reckon that's probably about 25 ounces, which takes us past the Hoffmans.
I think he should have learned by now.
So that's 353 ounces.
353 ounces, were $388,000.
So that takes us to $3,362.
Let's turn the scale on here and see what we got cooking.
To cover his overhead and stay afloat, Steve needs to clear $1.5 million in gold this season.
By golly, some nice little chunkies in there.
Yep, we hit a pretty hot spot out there.
1982 times 0.9 times 96.85 equals $155,328.03.
Well, that's better than a $96 paycheck than I used to get when I was working as a young boy.
Yes, indeed.
The massive payday is definitely a step in the right direction.
So easy to put in a jar, but so hard to get out of the ground.
You need a hand for that?
Damn here, actually.
Are you a
No, I just like my money in my pocket.
Are you a bleep?
To stay on target for Tony's 2,000-ounce goal, they need this cleanup to deliver at least 100 ounces.
90, 100, 120, 200, 230, 240, 300, 340, 370, 380, 390, 400, 420.
That's pretty amazing.
Jesus.
It's all golden.
480.
Gonna get over five or what?
Well, I think we will.
Wow.
500.
Well,
need a bigger pen.
20. 532.6.
Wow, that's pretty good, isn't it?
That's okay. Huh? Yeah.
Worth almost $640,000. 532 ounces is the largest gold weigh-in in Gold Rush's 7-year history.
Anyway.
Our best so far was, what, 277?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
damn
the
doubled it.
Doubled it.
Kevin, I can smell those 2,000 ounces from here. If you can do one like that every 14 days, we'll be there ASP. That justifies getting up. That's over there, wouldn't you think so? Can you imagine if you got that twice?
Don't count your chickens before they hatch.